One of the key visions for the DARPA Subterranean Challenge is the creation of technologies that can transcend the diversity of the environments that they face in the underground. And what we're seeking to do here with our competitors is to provide that environment that stresses the ability to be adaptable across all those subdomains. We've seen teams compete in that tunnel environment, and now we're progressing to that urban underground environment where they're gonna face wholly new challenges, and we'll see how quickly and readily they're able to adapt to those challenges. Urban environments can present a lot of complexity with floor plans that include countless rooms, hallways, and many levels to explore. Any corridor may lead to a dead end, or to a large open area like a warehouse, or it may be lined by a row of rooms, all that need to be exhaustively searched. There may be countless ways to get where you want to go, so robots have to be careful about how they plan their exploration paths. Every new opening could just be a single room, or it could lead to an entirely new section of the unknown environment. Larger rooms may have rows and rows of storage or other obstacles that take a lot of time to make sure you've covered every corner. Especially in a disaster scenario, urban environments can present lots of challenging obstacles, including debris, large drop-offs, curbs, narrow corridors and doorways, and tight turns, all of which may be partially obstructed by debris. Urban environments are more than just a 2D floor plan. In order to get between levels, the robots may need to traverse stairs, ledges, elevator shafts, ladders, and even escalators. There may be mezzanine levels within levels, or shelves or ledges that are very high up, so it's not enough just to build a floor plan. The robots have to explore the entire 3D environment. Vertical terrain features also means there's the possibility of large drop-offs, which are yet another hazard that robots have to constantly be aware of. Being designed for humans doesn't necessarily make urban environments easier for robots. Some terrain features that are easy for people are quite hard for robots, such as stairs, curbs, narrow corridors, and tight corners. Unlike the other subdomains, urban environments use human-made materials and often have smooth surfaces and a lot of right angles. While that can simplify some things, it can also mean fewer features for robots to track, which can lead to large localization errors and drift. One way teams are seeking to overcome these challenges is by having different types of robots to address different aspects of the problem. So you may have a robot that is good at negotiating stairs, but isn't able to see artifacts that are high up. Or you may have a robot that can quickly navigate long corridors and has a long battery life, but can't get past sharp turns or narrow doors. Some robots may not have the payload to carry sensors that can see through fog, so they'll have to pair up with robots that do. The complex environments would take a really long time to exhaustively explore with just one robot, so many teams are taking the approach by dividing and conquering this environment. We're super excited to welcome all the competitors to the urban circuit for the DARPA Subterranean Challenge. I'm particularly excited to see many of those lessons learned turn into reality, as well as new innovations that they've brought to face the urban environment.